Good morning to all the people present here today. Myself Shivani of BSc MPCS second year of Vivekananda Government Degree College, which is in Vidyanagar. And today I just want to say a few lines about our Abul Pakir Zainuddin Abdul Kalam. It is always inspiring and refreshing to read his works. And APJ Abdul Kalam sir was born on 15th October 1931 and was born to Zainuddin and Ashiyamma in Rameshwaram. As a young boy, he sold newspapers to support his family merged income. After his college education, he joined St. Joseph College in Tiruchirappalli and then moved on to Madras Institute of Technology. He worked mainly at the Defense Research and Development Organization and Indian Space Research Organization. In July 2002, he became the President of India. He authored a number of books. He loved teaching. He was honored with the 40 doctorates. The government of India conferred on him the national highest civilization honor, Bharat Ratna, in 1997. But most significantly, he won the hearts of millions of people as a Vishwaguru, a Muslim, and a people's president. Thank you.
Very good. Very good. Very good, Shivani. Very nice.
Very nice. Beautifully.
You were, Shivani, you were reading from a text, ma?
Yes, ma'am. That's from our first year book.
Yeah. So, since you were reading, my only advice to you is your language is good, your pronunciation is good. You should have just slowed down, okay? Your pace of delivery should have been slower, so then there would have been more clarity, okay? So go slow, and so then it will be more clearer, okay? Otherwise, well done. And since you just did it for the first time, very, very nicely done, very nicely done.
Anything else? Beautifully done, man. Good pronunciation. She had jotted down the points, ma'am. It was not exactly. I could see the paper that she was holding. But beautifully, well done in the
and
limited
Abdul
time.
Abdul Kalam is an inspiration. All of us should read. And you picked up Abdul Kalam. That is very, very nice, you know. And
I'm having a question.
I was just going through my old books and I got the topic.
Very good, Arindam
and
has
you
a
have good potential. You have a lot of potential, ma. You can improve.
Shivani, Arindam has a question for you, Nana.
Fine, ask her.
I think we'll have to give the other girl a chance.
I want to ask that many students are there, like me, those who don't prefer reading books or going through any kind of topics. I don't go through topics on internet or going through books. I just overcome with my natural capability, what all I have earned since my childhood, I just go with that only. So what steps can be taken regarding APJ Abdul Kalam in our college so that the students gain some good things from the great person?
Ma'am, I would like to answer this.
Please go ahead.
Arindam, welcome. As Shivani said, he went to MIT, Madras Institute of Technology. He did his aeronautical engineering. Later, when he completed his engineering, he aspired to become a pilot. He aspired to become first pilot from his place, Rameshwaram. But what happened is, at the same time, he got two interview call letters. One is from for aircraft designing, and one is for to become a pilot. Fortunately, he passed in aircraft designing, but he lost in becoming a pilot. Like after he got depressed, and he went that interview taken place in Dehradun. After he got depressed, and he went to Haridwar, just near to Dehradun, Haridwar, and he went and he met a Swami, and that Swami asked him why you were so depressed. He said that he lost his interview, which he likes it. So Swami said, "Don't get worried. You got a job in aircraft designing. God don't know where He want to take you. So don't get worried and just believe in your hard work and move on." Finally, he became a president of India. In his book Wings on Fire, he mentioned that our failures will take us to somewhere else where God decides us to keep somewhere. So it is a good sign for me to fail in the pilot training interview. So that's the reason I became president of India. So what I'd like to say is, like, we can take that if we fail in our lives, that it leads to something big that we take to settle. God decides us to keep right there. So that's one of the good things we can take it from Abhijit Abdullah's life.
Excellent. Yes, means you want to conclude that according to Abdul Kalam, it's mentioned that if you're suffering from failure, you should not stick on to the failure. You should move on with accepting the failures in your life.
Yeah.
And whatever opportunities are provided, because, you know, God provides these opportunities because he, or fate or whatever you want to call it, whatever opportunity is provided to you, we make best use of it and we go places with that. You know, if you're denied something, then, you know, just let go. Don't hang on to that is what Yashwant is trying to say about Kallam.
Yes,
said,
ma'am.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. I would like to put one point to Arvindam. I would say that, yes, you go by your instincts, but Arvindam, if you read books, that will be an added advantage.
Yes.
So please,
for somebody who is, who is bright and intelligent and, you know, like you, you should consolidate the knowledge. Of course, you're too young. Yes, 18, 19. Yes, how much of world experience do you have to fall back on? But books is going to open the world before you.